He was a big hero of many of us, a big hero of mine when it was age 11. Yeah, 1 Million Years BC was one of my favourite films. I was a big dinosaur fanatic. And it's actually that movie that made me pick up a home movie camera and start making those films at home with the hobby. Yeah. We even named the two dinosaurs there.
The sushi restaurant they go to is Harryhausen, where it's very hard to get a reservation. But I also wondered, since the time of well, not a million years ago, I mean, we're talking my childhood too. Stop motion has advanced so much, and I'm wondering about the challenges of recreating that style that was in many ways cruder, and I think the puppets were less responsive than the ones you're dealing with now. And what are the challenges of kind of bringing back that kind of the look of that film?
You were in charge of that.
Knowing that part of the plan was to make it feel very, very Harryhausen-esque, we did go right back to that original reference. And the animator that worked on that scene adapted the style a bit, so it had a slightly more, you know, Ray Harryhausen feel to it. But I think the puppets he used, although they were, it was a long time ago, they were incredibly well made, because you got an amazing sort of life and character out of them. So it was quite a challenge because we were using new materials and technology to recreate these very old puppets, but even then we had limitations that, you know, that he obviously must have dealt with somehow.
I remember watching Sacrilegious because we shot the whole thing on digital cameras as opposed to the film camera. So the whole sequence for the opening looked immaculate. Well, the whole film looked immaculate on digital. So we had to do the sacrilegious thing of an ironically treating it to make it look like 1970s. the original movies of putting sparkle on and funny use of digital
dust.
And slightly making the colours more permanent. Yeah.
Although one thing I hope you didn't emulate is Harryhausen told me a story that one of his first films he did, wanted to do a cave bear, and he cut its skin out of his mother's fur coat. You get in trouble. One of the things that you and the Arvins have done is raise the kind of lip sync animation in stop motion to that no one had done before. If you look at the stop motion for Pal or Clokey, no one did it as subtly and as nuanced as you do. And I wondered if you could talk a little bit about how, you know, when you create the character, how do you find the voice and then meld it to the puppet? That, you know, how, when you're thinking of Doug or is that the AOI character who's next to him with the one leg?
No, that's actually one of the cavemen out of the prologue.
Yeah.
I'll try to be called.
It's an anthropological term. Those of you who really study early man in school went to the prologians.
It was a very accurate historic documentary.
We couldn't really afford to create the prologue tribe, so we took the tribe that we know, and we kind of doctored them all.
I think this one's brother, isn't it?
Yeah.
So literally, it's something that, because we work in modeling plane, we use a basic mantle replacement system, which is not unusual, which is something that that Arden and Nick introduced on Wrong Trouser or Close Shave, correct me which one it was. But when it changed from Nick animating on Close Shave, when more animators had to come in and start working the same style, what it does is it means that we have the basic mouth shapes, those kind of things. But because it's play, if there's any subtlety in the performer's performance, the animator can actually mould and manipulate the mouth to accommodate that, whether it's throwing the mouth to one side or just reducing the size of the mouth or the drop of the teeth or whatever it is, which, if you're using a solid replacement or even sculpting through to a certain extent, you don't have that level of nuance. And it's just one of those things, once you get your eye in, it becomes, you know, it's actually quite easy once you've kind of got your head around what you need to do to listen to the sound, and then you can ask the characters. Hey.